Starting with the name of Allah, who is the most gracious and the most merciful. Assalamu alaikum. My name is Iman Zahid from the department based biotechnology, and the topic assigned to me is atomic emission spectroscopy. Moving towards the topic, atomic emission spectroscopy is a method of chemical analysis that uses the intensity of light emitted from a flame, plasma, arc or spark at a particular wavelength to determine the quantity of an element in a sample. The wavelength of the atomic spectral line in the emission spectrum gives the identity of the element, while the intensity of the emitted light is proportional to the number of atoms of the element. The sample may be excited by various methods. The diagram of atomic emission spectroscopy is shown here. The origin of atomic emission spectrum of an element is that when atoms absorb energy, their electrons move to higher energy levels. The light emitted by an electron moving from a higher to a lower energy level has a frequency that is directly proportional to the energy change of the electron. In 1859, the German physicist Gustav Robert Kirchhoff and chemist Robert Wilhelm Eberhard von Bunsen discovered that spectral lines are unique to each element. Quantitative applications based on the atomic emission from electric sparks were developed by Lockyer in early 1870, and quantitative applications based on the flame emission were pioneered by Lundegaard in 1930. Atomic emission based on the emission from plasma was introduced in 1964. Principle: the electrons of an atom moves from higher energy levels to lower energy levels. They emit extra amount of energy in the form of light, which consists of photons. When energy is absorbed by electrons of an atom, electrons move to lower energy levels to higher energy levels, as shown in the diagram. These excited electrons have to radiate energy to return to ground states from the excited states, which is unstable. The emission spectrum is formed by the frequencies of these emitted light. Instrumentation. Following are the instruments used in the atomic emission spectroscopy: source and sample, atomizer, monochromator, detector, and the readout device. The instruments are explained as source and sample. The flame source consists of total consumption burner, in which sample is drawn through a capillary tube which is injected directly into the flame, and the flame is high temperature source used to dissolve it and vaporize a sample to generate free atom for spectroscopic study. Atomizer. The atomizer produces fine spray from the liquid. It works on Bernoulli's principle. Atomic emission spectroscopy uses analyte atoms in solution that are aspirated to excited region, where they are dissolved, vaporized, and atomized by the flame, discharge, or plasma. Monochromator. Two monochromators are used in the atomic emission spectroscopy. One used to select the excitation wavelength, and a second one is used to analyze the emitted light. Detector. A detector is used right after the monochromator. As eluents come off the capillary column, they are fed into the discharge cavity, where the compounds are destroyed and the atoms are excited by energy of plasma. Readout device. At the end of the apparatus is the readout device, that the quantity of the sample coming from the flame and the detector, and displays the measurement on the screen. Working. Atomic emission spectroscopy uses quantitative measurement of the optical emission from excited atoms to determine analyte concentration. Atomic emission occurs when a valence electron in a higher energy atomic orbital returns to lower energy atomic orbital. It shows a portion of the energy level diagram for sodium, which consists of a series of discrete lines at wavelengths corresponding to the difference in energy between two atomic orbitals. An atomic emission spectrometer is similar in design to the instrumentation of atomic absorption. In fact, it is easy to adapt most flame atomic absorption spectrometers for atomic emission by turning off the hollow cathode lamp and monitoring the difference between the emission intensity when aspirating the sample and aspirating a blank. Atomic emission spectroscopy works the moment beam source hits the beam chopper and monochromator passes beam of light towards the detector. Atomic emission spectroscopy is ideally suited for multi-elemental analysis because all the analytes in a sample are excited simultaneously. If the instrument includes a scanning monochromator, we can program it to move rapidly to analyte's desired wavelength, pause to record its emission intensity, and then move to the next analyte's wavelength. This sequential analysis allows for a sampling rate of 3 to 4 analytes per minute. Another approach to a multi-elemental analysis is to use a multi-channel instrument that allows to monitor simultaneously many analytes. A simple design for multi-channel spectrometer couples a monochromator with multiple detectors that are positioned in a semicircular array around the monochromator at positions that correspond to the wavelengths for the analytes, as illustrated here. types of sources. There are a number of different types of excitation sources used in the atomic emission spectroscopy. The primary emission sources used in the atomic emission spectroscopy today are the following: AC or DC arcs, high, medium or low voltage sparks, glow discharge with flat or hollow cathode, inductively coupled plasmas, lasers, direct current plasmas, capacitively coupled microwave plasmas, microwave induced plasmas, furnaces and exploding wire or foils. Mostly used source. Inductively coupled plasmas have grown in popularity in analytical spectroscopy because the inductively coupled plasma offers advantages over other excitation source options. Attempting to explain all the advantages that ICP offer over each of the other excitation sources listed above would take away from the main focus of this site, which is to explain how inductively coupled plasma atomic emission spectroscopy works. So it will not be attempted. A simple explanation as to why inductively coupled plasmas is advantageous to the use in design and excitation source, and the temperature achieved in the plasma allow for a more efficient interaction between the sample being studied and the excitation source, which leads to greater sensitivity, greater accuracy, greater precision and greater atomic excitation as well. Drawbacks. There are certain drawbacks of atomic emission spectroscopy as loss of analyte during the ashing stage, incomplete atomization, more operating cost, procedures are complicated, low precision and accuracy, viscous samples require dilution with solvent. Advantages. Some of the advantages of atomic emission spectroscopy include small sample size, little or no sample preparation required, enhanced sensitivity, direct analysis of solid samples, emission spectra are obtained under a single set of excitation conditions, and several elements can be recorded simultaneously. Multi-element can be analyzed from a very small sample, very high concentration range for plasma sources, and various others. Applications. It is very useful for the determination of alkali and alkaline earth metals, used in the determination of lead in petrol, used in the determination of calcium and magnesium in cement, to detect elements in plants and soil. Thus, metal deficiency in plants and soil can be diagnosed. There are a number of other applications of atomic emission spectroscopy used in different aspects of light. That's all related to this topic. Thank you.